Loco-Motion, Loco-Motion Station. Loco-Motion, Loco-Motion Station. We're here to learn, have fun and play. At Loco-Motion Station, it's always a wonderful day.
Hi, boys and girls at home. Thanks for joining us here today. In our class at Loco-Motion Station, we have a show about safety and how to keep safe, a very important topic. So thanks for joining us today, and I hope you do some of the activities right along with us. You can do them at home. I'm Miss Lynelle, and I'm the conductor here at Loco-Motion Station. And with us, as always, is Engineer Chris. Can we all say hi to Engineer Chris? Are you ready? Hi, Engineer Chris.
Hello, everybody. I am the railroad man, I drive the train along. The wheels, they roll from gold to gold. The whistle blows her song. Around each turn, more things we learn, new lessons every day. When we pull into each station, all across the nation, a child's imagination leads the way.
Thanks, Engineer Chris.
You're welcome.
We also have some boys and girls here who have joined us to be our class today and help us with all the activities about safety. So let's meet them. Let's see who we have over here. Hi, what's your name?
Dalton.
Dalton, how old are you, Dalton?
7.
7 years old. Thanks for being here. And what is your name?
My name is
Charlotte. And how old are you, Charlotte? 3 years old. Great. Let's see who we have at this table. Hi, what's your name?
Alex.
And how old are you, Alex?
4 and a half.
4 and a half. Excellent. And next to you, what's your name?
4 and a half.
You're 4 and a half. Great. And what's your name?
Nick.
Are you brothers? You're both exactly 4 and a half? Do you have the same birthday? Yep. That must mean you're twins, right? All right. And who do we have here? What's your name? What?
Riley.
Riley. How old are you, Riley?
I'm just 4 years old.
You just turned 4?
Yeah.
Well, happy birthday to you. The first thing that we're going to do in our class that we do each class is the Pledge of Allegiance, all right? So I'm going to go get the flags. And I think we had Dalton and Charlotte as both holding the American flag. And we have... do the three of you want to come up, all three hold? Do you want to come up, Riley? Okay, y'all hold the Texas flag. Okay, you can go over there if you want, Riley. We're going to look at the flags, or you can stand here with me. We're going to put our right hand over our heart. Friends at home, this is your right hand, and it goes over your heart. And Riley, go ahead and look right at the flags over there. We're going to say the pledge to the American flag first, okay? Ready?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And now let's say the Texas pledge. Ready? Honor the Texas flag.
I pledge allegiance to the Texas flag. One state, under God, one and indivisible.
Very nice, thank you. All right, if you can go back to your seats and I'll put the flags back. So let's get started talking about safety. One thing that we need to know is what to do in case of an emergency. Riley, do you know what an emergency is?
No, there's real food.
I know. Who knows what an emergency is? Yes.
Emergency is when somebody is really hurt.
Yes, somebody is really hurt and we need help quickly, right? So we might have to have a fireman come if there's a fire, or a policeman come, or an ambulance, somebody's hurt or sick. But let's talk about what would be an emergency, because it's important to know. Is losing your toy an emergency to call 911? Would we do that for losing your toy? No. If your house is on fire, is that an emergency? Yes, we want to call 911. Okay, is having a runny nose, sniffly nose an emergency? No, but let's say your mom or dad fell down, they can't get back up again. Is that an emergency? Yes, that's something serious. If your brother takes your stuffed animal and runs in his room, would that be stealing and that's an emergency? No, he said yeah. No, but what if somebody was stealing your car outside? Is that an emergency? Yes, we would need to call 911. 911 can get us the police or a fire truck or an ambulance. And I have a picture of an ambulance. This is what an ambulance looks like. Has anybody seen one of these before, maybe on the streets? If you're sick or hurt, 911 will send an ambulance. Okay, now we never call 911 unless we have a real emergency, right? It needs to be for people who really need help immediately, right away. Okay, but I have a song that will help us to remember the number. This says, in case of emergency, call 911, okay? So we have a song that helps us remember that. And it's to the tune of The Bear Went Over the Mountain, which you're probably familiar with. Call 911 for an ambulance. Call 911 for an ambulance. Call 911 for an ambulance. If someone needs some help, you'll hear the sirens, see flashing lights. You'll hear the sirens, see flashing lights. You'll hear the sirens, see flashing lights. Help is on the way. The ambulance will come. The ambulance will come. The ambulance will come and help and save your friend today.
So that helps us with the number. Call 911 for an ambulance.
Okay, so we have also some phones that I made here. And friends at home, you could make something like this at home. You could write the numbers on, just trace around what looks like a phone, write the numbers, and we're gonna practice punching in 911. So let's each take a phone, and those are the only three numbers you have to dial. Okay, so let's practice. Can you punch in 911? Let's see how you're all doing it. Can you do it again? 911. Oh, that's very important. Yes, this is the 9 right here. And you know Dalton? Yes. Over here, can you point to the 9? That's going to be the 9. Good. Can you point to the 9? Okay, so we're dialing that 1. Now hit the 1. Does everybody see the 1? 1-1. We have to do it 2 times. Let's do it again. 9-1-1. Very good. All right, now I think we can practice. We're always only going to practice using a toy phone. Friends at home, if you have a toy phone, you can practice 911. This phone is not plugged into anything, so an ambulance is not going to come, or a fire truck. Okay, but let's come and do a little pretend like acting. Okay, Dalton, you want to come up here? And I'm going to be the operator, and then I'm going to tell you what to say. Okay, when I say 911, what's your emergency? Would you say my house is on fire? Okay, let's pretend. Press 911. 911, what's your emergency? We'll send somebody right away. Okay, good. All right, Charlotte, you wanna come up? All right, so you pick up the phone. Okay, do you know where the 9 is? Can you see from? Very good. Mm-hmm, see, our paper phone helped us learn that. Excellent. 911, what's your emergency? Say, my mommy fell down, she can't get up.
My mommy fell down, can't get up.
Very good. Awesome. We'll send somebody to your house right away. Okay, good. Riley, do you want to call? Okay, pick up the phone. And right here, 9. Press the 9. You have to press down. 9. Now press down. It's important to press the buttons. 1 and press 1 again. 1. Okay. Why don't you say, my daddy's really sick. He told me to call. You. Okay. 911, what's your emergency?
My dad's sick.
Okay. I'll send an ambulance right away, okay?
Okay.
Very good. Okay, why don't you all come up? Alex, why don't you both come up here? All right, so what's the number to call? Let's see, do you remember at home what the number to call is? What are you gonna dial?
911.
Perfect. 911, what's your emergency? Why don't you say, my house is on fire.
My house is on fire.
I'm going to send a fire truck right away, okay? Get out of your house, all right?
Okay.
Yeah, if your house is on fire, you don't stay in there, do you?
Yeah.
Okay, you wanna call? Let's see if Nick remembers the number. 911. This one two times, 1-1. You just press it two times. Yeah, there you go. Okay, 911, what's your emergency? Can you think of something or you want me to tell you? How about tell them my mommy's really, really sick? Uh-oh. Say, I need help. Just say, I need help. You can say that too if you're not sure. Anyone want to say that for me? I say, I need help.
No.
No, okay. I need help. Okay, they're going to send somebody right away. Wow. So that is important to know how to call 911, right? So we did a lot of practicing with that. So you will know in case there's an emergency at your house and you have to do that. And there have been kids that have had to call 911 and they've been heroes when they save somebody at their house. But we have to remember we never ever dial that number unless it's really an emergency. Well, there's another thing that we need to know how to be safe, and that is how to cross the street safely. So we have a special guest that's coming. Her name is Miss Purple Urple, and she volunteers her time at the local school helping kids cross the street to get to school and home from school safely. She's going to be here any minute, so let's come out in front because I think she has a game we need to play. So let's come over here and see. Oh, there she is. Hi, Miss Purple Urple.
Hi, Miss Lynelle. How are you doing today?
Thank you for being here today.
So nice to have me again. Hi, kids. How are you doing today? We're learning all about safety today, aren't we? Riley and Dalton, and Alex and Charlotte and Nick. So nice to have y'all here to learn all about safety. It's very important, safety is, don't you think, Nick? It is. I'm sure that you all have seen signs like this all over town, haven't you? When you walk, when you're in the car, when you walk with your family, you probably see stop signs because this is a very, very popular stop sign, right? They're all over the place. A lot of times they're in the ground on the side of the cross sections in the street, right? But if you go to school, you might see the crossing guards, and they wear these very bright reflective vests so that you can tell who's supposed to help you cross the street, right? Because you want to be able to tell who's there to help you. And the sign has one side that says stop completely, and we know when it's red, and the shape, of course, too, definitely lets us know that it's stop. On the other side, it says slow, and we know that we walk slow. And Miss Purple Urple brought a really fun game that I made up. Would y'all like to play that game with me real quick?
Yeah.
Okay, well, I'm going to put this big sign down, and we're going to switch over to these small signs. These are just little colored paddles, and for each paddle color, I'm going to teach you guys what I want you to do so that we can learn how to cross the street better. And be really safe, okay? Depending on what color I hold up, it's gonna depend on how you cross the street and come to me. And I'm gonna give you real quick. If I put the yellow, we're gonna look both ways before we cross the street, and then we're gonna exaggerate our slow motion, right? We're gonna go slow. Can we look up and go in slow? Can you show Ms. Purple? Slow. If I put up the red, what does that mean? It means stop! Right? Yeah, we have to stop where we're at. If I put up the green, we're going to. Again, look both ways before you cross the street. Now, we're not gonna run, right? And we're not gonna go slow on a green light. We can move at a normal pace. You move towards me. If I put up the red, what happens? We stop again, right? Absolutely. So hold on right there. Let me move back a little bit. Let's see.
Should we move back again?
Absolutely.
Okay, let's give us some more room so we have some distance to cross.
So we're gonna start on, where would we go if I put this up?
Red.
We wouldn't move at all, would we? You're so smart, that's wonderful. So if I put up the yellow, what are we going to do? But we have to look both ways first, right? You want to look both ways. Never walk across the street until you look both ways. So you're going to move slowly towards me, right? Slowly. And then we're going to stop. Good job. And then if we put up the green, what are we going to do?
Go.
But first, we're going to look both ways. We need to make sure that nobody's coming.
No cars.
So we get to move how? We move at a regular pace until we have, stop. And we're going to come back again with my green. And we're coming towards me now. And we look, good job, Dalton. Look both ways. And we keep coming. We keep coming. We're almost across the street. Stop. And I think we did a great job.
Yay!
Very good.
And
we always have to advantage Miss Purple Urple because it's fun.
Thank you, Miss Purple Urple. Well, I think to get to the story tree today, we're going to go in our cars, but we don't have real cars, do we? But we can always pretend. And friends at home, if you want to pretend to get in the car and drive around with us to the story tree. All right, so first, let's have our car right here. I think my car is blue. Do you have a color for your car?
Mine is pink.
Pink.
Mine is yellow.
Yellow car?
Mine is red.
Red?
Green.
Green. Everybody has a different color. Okay, great. Let's take out our keys. Open the door. Climb in the car. Close the door. Okay, get your key in the ignition and start that engine. Sounds pretty good. I'm going to step on my gas pedal. Okay, and Miss Purple Urple may give us some traffic signs along the way. So let's ask Engineer Chris to play us some driving music, okay? So say, Engineer Chris, please play. Engineer Chris, please play. So come with us and drive along, and drive along, and drive along. So come with us and drive along to the story tree today. We will obey the traffic signs, the traffic signs, the traffic signs. We will obey the traffic signs at the... we got stopped by the traffic sign. So we'll just wait and see what happens. Oh, slow. We're going to drive slow, okay? So come with us and drive along, and drive along, and drive along. So come with us and drive along to the story tree today. We will obey the traffic signs, the traffic signs, the traffic signs. We will obey the traffic... Oh, I saw it! Did you see it? Turned us off, okay. All right, here we go. To the story tree today. Here we are. So here we are at the story tree, and Miss Purple Urple has a story for us.
So we're going to read a story, and the name of this book is What to Do When Your Mom or Dad Says, Be Careful. And it's written by Joy Berry, and the pictures are by Bartholomew. And this is a very, very... Has your mother or father ever told you to be careful? I bet they have, haven't they? Yeah, moms and dads say that a lot. I'm a mommy and a grandma, and I know I say that a lot. When your parents tell you to be careful, do you wonder? What do they mean? What is he supposed to do, the little froggy's saying? If this sounds familiar to you, you're going to love this book. Why? Yeah, why, they want to know. Well, because we're going to learn all about how to be careful in different areas that you encounter on a daily basis. Be careful with dangerous things. Do not use any of the following items without adult supervision. We would never get a hold of an aerosol or a spray can. Chemicals, if you see a bottle, and I think Miss Lynelle has a picture.
I do. I have some things. Well, you want to read through those first,
okay,
and then I'll show these?
Absolutely. You wouldn't want to touch a knife or any other sharp object or utensil. You wouldn't want to touch a razor. You wouldn't want to handle dangerous recreational equipment. You wouldn't want to be playing around electrical appliances. You need to be careful if you see an electrical cord, right? Absolutely. If you see matches or cigarette lighters, you wouldn't want to pick those up and play with them. That's not a good thing to do. It's dangerous. If you had fireworks, you'd need to be very careful. And we'd never try to have a firework by ourselves, right? We'd always want to have mom or dad with us to help us with the fireworks, right? Absolutely. We never want to have guns, Sometimes we have play guns. Sometimes play guns look a lot like a real gun. So it's always best to ask a parent, can I play with that gun? Is that a play gun? And it's just best not even to touch it unless we know for sure and a parent gives it to you and says, this is a water gun. It's okay to play with. Anything else, it's better to be safe. And that means don't touch it all, okay?
So we have some pictures here of things you would not want to play with. An iron, why not? Yeah, Dalton.
Burn.
Mm-hmm. This is bleach. Sometimes you find it around the washing machine. Mm-hmm. Don't touch, right?
Mm-hmm. No, no.
Poison. A lot of times poison will have the skull and crossbones on it, so we know. Don't never do that. Matches. Mm-hmm. We don't want to touch those, right? A knife. She was talking about that. We don't play with knives.
Mm-hmm.
This is an electrical outlet that we plug into, but we don't put our finger in it or touch it, right? Has electricity in it.
Or ever stick anything in it.
Medicine? No, we don't want to ever open or touch any medicine bottles.
Absolutely.
We don't know what that is.
Absolutely.
Barbecue? Those can be hot. It's good to eat things that are barbecued, right? But then we don't want to touch while mom or dad's cooking on the barbecue.
No, be very careful.
A lighter? Have you ever seen one of these? Yeah, we don't want to play with that. That has fire in it. Right, yeah, and the mom or dad has to light your birthday candles, right?
Exactly.
Only they touch the lighter.
And I can take the candles out.
You can, after they're blown
out,
you can touch the candles then, right? A steaming pot, a pot that's on the stove, we don't touch, right? That would burn us, okay? So those are just some pictures of things we don't want to touch.
Yes.
And we're going to. The little fingers.
Mm-hmm.
Like I did yesterday by the door, I blew my.
Sorry. And it just reminded me, when we get back in our cars, even though they're pretend cars, what should we put on? Yes, even in our pretend car, we'll practice that, okay? Come on, let's get back in our cars.
Yay!
Okay, ooh, stop! Here we are, back at the class. Let's get out of our cars. And lock them up. And we'll come over here because I know Engineer Chris has a safety rap to sing to us. It's going to teach us about safety.
Okay. Look left, look right. When there's not a car in sight, you may cross the street if you will hold my hand. When you've looked hard all around, listen careful for a sound. Don't walk until it's safe to, so you end up where you planned. Be aware before you wander over there. Be certain you are wearing something bright. If you cross where cars are driving and you're planning on arriving, take mom or dad along. Look left, look right. And grown-ups, in your car, please take stock of where you are. If you're near a school or playground, slow it down. Children playing in the street depend on you to be discreet. If the bus is stopped and flashing, don't be rude and drive around. Always stop, or you'll be dealing with a cop. If he stops you, you don't want to see him frown. So where children are concerned, the thing you'd best have learned is when you see a child, just slow it down. Look left, look right. Carry a flashlight if it's night, especially if you're walking near the cars. And to make sure you're not hit, take a street that's brightly lit. No one's ever gonna see you by the dim light of the stars. If it's dark, don't go biking through the park. You never know what's lurking in the night. You know you can't go wrong if you take mom or dad along. Just play it safe and do look left and right.
Yay! I like that rap, don't you? Very good. Thank you, Engineer Chris, and Miss Purple Urple too. Well, now we are going to make a snack. And it is a traffic light snack. All you have to do is get a graham cracker and you can spread it. I used some vanilla icing to just spread on there to make it sticky. You could use cream cheese or peanut butter or marshmallow cream maybe, whatever you'd like. And then we're going to put on some jelly beans, or not jelly beans, gumdrops. And we're going to put red on top because when a stoplight is like this, the red goes on the top. Okay, you don't have to eat those. You can take them off. They can just, it can just be like a craft as well. Or you could use M&Ms or something like that if you make them at home. And then there's the yellow in the middle and the green. So let's review. Red means stop. Yellow means go slow or cautious. And green means go. All right. So I'm going to give you each a plate and we'll make them together. Friends at home, this is something you can make as well. Okay, everybody put the red one on top. Oh, Charlotte's already got it all done. Can you put your red on top? And then next, put your yellow in the middle and your green on the bottom. And sometimes we see traffic lights, they're turned like that too. Yeah, no, we're not gonna use any more. I think we've got plenty of frosting on there. Okay, very nice. If you want to show friends at home yours, you can pick it up and show them. So while you're eating your snack, we're going to say happy birthday to some friends at home who have recently had birthdays. We have Carson, who is 4. Kayla is 4. Jessica is 10 years old. Corbin is 4 years old. Isabel is 5 years old. Mia, here's Mia and Alan, they're both 2. Laurel is 7 years old. Ivan is 2. Adam is 5. Happy birthday, Dominic. He's 8. Lola turned 9 years old. Emma is 3 years old. Leo is 8. And Marissa is 4 years old. We have Aiden, who's 5. And here's Meredith. She turned 6 years old. Jacob is 4. Delilah is 7. And happy birthday, Baxter. Baxter is now 6 years old. And we can also say happy birthday to Riley. You just recently had a birthday, right? So happy birthday to all our friends at home. But I want to say thank you to all the friends at home for joining us today. And thank you to Miss Purple Urple. Miss Purple Urple, you want to come out and we'll say thank you?
Thank you.
Thanks for being here. Thank you to Engineer Chris for all his wonderful music. And thanks to Riley and Nick and Alex and Charlotte and Dalton. We'll see you next time on Loco-Motion Station. Bye-bye.
I am the railroad man. I love each mile of track. Long we go through rain and snow, never looking back. Up hills we climb, we love the time we spend with you each day. When we pull into our destination, Loco-Motion Station, where a child's imagination leads the way. Bye, everybody.